We now join all my children in progress.
Like it's a part of me, you know what I'm saying?
Listen, you're not going to have time to think about Bush League stuff like that anymore.
We can make time, man. Jenny and Greg, they're depending on me.
Jesse, let me put it this way. You agreed.
Only to the talent part. Why do I have to sell my share of the steam pit? We can just go with the talent part until we get rolling or something like that. How's that? Come on, man. Give me a break.
It's a two-part deal, Jess.
Wait, come on, man. Give me a break here. You don't understand.
Hello?
Yes. I'm trying to get in touch with Marvin Krupa. Is he there, please?
Yeah. Would you hold on just a moment, please? Mr. Krupa?
What?
Telephone to you.
Sure. Excuse me, Jess. Yeah.
Phil, it's Adam.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
Look, wrap that deal up immediately and get back here. I need you for something much more important.
Jesse, I don't want you to get railed into anything, and that's the feeling I get. Look, if there's something that you don't want to do, don't do it.
You know, I really don't want to sell my car. You know, I'm not part of the steam fit.
Don't.
I see.
The only thing, man, how can I turn down a chance to sign with one of the biggest talent agencies in the country? AFA.
I understand. Well, I'll be there just as soon as I can, right? Okay, I'll see you. Right. Hey, it's the coast. Sorry, man, I gotta get to that plane, so what do you say?
Okay, I'll tell you what. Why don't you go ahead, man? I gotta take a little more time on this. I gotta think about it, okay?
I'll tell you what, Sessie. You don't have any time for this. Unless I have those fees in my hand when I walk out that door, this deal's off. All right? What do you say?
I let you in, man. It ain't as easy as I thought it was gonna be.
I'll get it.
Okay. Now, come on, Jesse. I don't have any time. Let's go.
Oh, Jenny, hi. Come on, baby. Jesse, fine.
Jenny, what are you doing here?
Well, I just wanted to talk to you.
This is Marvin Krupa, the man I was telling you about from the talent agency. This is Jenny Gardner.
Hi.
It's nice
Jenny
to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Don't I know you? Remember?
Me? No, believe me, if we'd met before, I would have known it, really.
No, I think we have met. Your name isn't Krupa.
My name isn't Krupa.
No, really, it's... Now I remember. You work for Adam Chandler.
Mrs. Valentine. Never mind. Good evening, Liza.
Good evening, Professor Wallingford. Is Mrs. Wallingford in?
No, I'm sorry, but she isn't.
Oh, well, I guess I can talk to you. May I?
Of course.
Your wife called my father about the campaign against the gambling mall. Participating.
Oh, well, I certainly hope we can count on your father's support.
Oh, of course, but you see, my father, he hasn't really been feeling well since we got back from our trip. And he asked if I could substitute for him this evening.
Oh, really?
Well, yes, I would do anything that would help you out.
Well, that's very kind of you, but Mrs. Wallingford is the field marshal in this operation, and as I said, she's not here just now.
Oh, well, I'll wait for her.
Unfortunately, Liza, I'm not sure how long she'll be gone. You see, she's at the courthouse awaiting the judge's injunction, which may prevent the Chandlers from making this awful mess.
Oh, well, I would love to wait and hear what the judge's decision was.
Liza, dear, do be sensible and go on home. It's for your own good.
I'm sorry, what do you mean?
Well, very likely friends of Phoebe's will be dropping in later on.
Well, that's fine. I mean, I know practically everyone in Pine Valley.
Yes, and they know you. And I don't think you should be subjected to them.
Subjected?
Well, how can I be more plain? I think that you would be uncomfortable in their presence.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wallingford, I don't understand.
Well, you forced me to be blunt. The fact is, Liza, your recent events in your life have caused considerable comment, and there are certain individuals who have been very critical about you.
Oh, I see. The reason that you don't want me here is because I have a reputation of being a bad girl?
Well, not everybody condemns you.
But you do, don't you?
No, that is not so. Unlike many others, I am not narrow-minded, a gossiper. I believe in giving you the credit of the doubt, and that I think that you're probably the innocent victim of this awful thing that happened to you.
You know, I think you are nothing but a hypocrite.
Oh, really, Liza?
Oh, I could say a lot worse. You and your wife and all the old bags in this hick town are really doing a number on me.
I was merely trying to be truthful. I think you'd better leave.
Oh, I would be happy to. And you want to know something else? I don't think you deserve my help.
I know a lot of people are going to be upset with all of this, Ellen. It's just if they could think of it as a recreational center, a sports arena, an amusement park. I mean, the mall itself is going to be a showcase of architectural design.
You make it sound very attractive.
Yes, but that's not the only attractive thing, the local economy. That'll get a boost itself, too.
Oh, you certainly don't have to justify that to me.
Well, then you approve.
Well, I think it's a very daring idea that took a lot of vision.
I wish everybody'd feel that way.
Oh, don't worry. I think the people who are opposing you now will be supporting you in the end.
Really? You really think so?
Oh, yes. Look, this gambling complex is going to fill the tax coffers, isn't it? So that means that local taxes will be practically nil, and they will love you.
That's exactly what I want to hear. But, there is one problem still.
Oh, what's that?
I hope you're not taken aback with the fact that I've not been too honest with you.
I think you're just being a smart businessman. I respect that.
Really?
Yes.
I mean, you don't think less of me.
No, I don't think it has anything to do with our friendship at all. Do you? I mean, look, if people have to take a stand, then I'm with you.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, great. Then I'll ask you to dinner tonight. How's that?
Oh, well, I never thought you'd ask.
Tell you what, we'll go to Center City. No, better that. We'll stop first at the house, and then we'll talk to Adam, and you'll tell him exactly what it is you told me. How's that?
Yes. Oh, I would love to do that.
I was on the yacht party in New York. You were representing the Chandlers.
Hey, everybody has a double, you know?
Are you sure, Jenny?
Yes, I am positive. Jesse, don't you see what's happening here? It's very clear this is just a scheme so Chandler can get your part of the steam pit.
Well, man, do you work for Adam Chandler?
Yes, I do. As a matter of fact, but that makes absolutely no difference, Jesse. Really, this could do you a lot of good. We're very well connected. I could make you a star overnight.
What'd you say this man, what's his name?
Philip Peters, that's what I know.
What's this Marvin Cooper stuff? Was that supposed to be some funny showbiz gimmick?
You could call that a presentation, Jesse, but really, the Chandler family has so many connections with the entertainment industry. This could...
I don't believe this. This blows me right out of the water, man. I don't believe Chandler would go through the trouble to try to get the steam pit from us again like this. Jenny, man, you saved us.
Jesse, it would be very advantageous for you to make this...
Yo, Jethro, I tell you what would be advantageous to you is if you went back to your master and you told him I wouldn't sell him a bucket of ice for a one-way ticket out of hell. And you know what you can do with your contract, man. You know what you can do with this mess. You take it and you get the hell out of my house. Jesse. You hear me, man? And don't you even think of coming back around here. Get the...
Jesse, you really didn't have to go that far.
Man, I swear the way I feel right now, I could kill that, man. I could kill that.
Tom? Tom? Wake up, son. It's me.
Father Terry, where am I?
You're home, son.
What are you doing here?
Brooke called me. Oh. I should have known.
How so?
She wanted you to find me like this. I don't think so. You don't know her the way I do. She's not what she seems. She's jealous, selfish. She hates me. Perhaps you should stop criticizing Brooke and start looking at yourself.
It'd be better for everybody all the way around if I just dropped dead.
Now that's the booze talking.
Sometimes the booze helps you see the truth. I'm a failure, I don't measure up.
You're only human like the rest of us. But in my judgment, you're one of God's fortunate creatures. You're blessed with good health and a good heart and enough brains to be happy and do some good. And when I see you like this, drunk and full of self-pity, I lose all patience.
Just forget about me.
Oh, Tom, if you can't stop the alcohol by yourself, get some help. Tom, you gotta get a hold of yourself. You gotta be the decent man I know you to be.
You give me one good reason.
You have a baby about to come into this world. Completely helpless, Tom. It's got to have a father to give it all the love and help it needs.
Obviously, Brooke hasn't told you. She's going to court, and she's gonna win. She won't let me anywhere near my baby. That's what's killing me.
Speaking with me now?
I'm substituting for Jenny. Can I show you to a table?
Oh, no, thank you. Don't strain yourself.
Oh, don't worry, I won't.
Certainly have changed.
Liza, this booth is off limits to personnel only. There's plenty of tables out there. Have a good time.
Well, I think I'd much rather stay here. Thank you. How's things? How's the weather? Oh, I don't mind the heat. It's the humidity that bothers me, I think. Oh, Greg, I think you've put on weight since you've been married.
Look, Liza, I don't have time for fun and games, okay?
Oh, Greg, please.
Look, I am trying to fill in for Jesse right now, and it's a tough job, so please, get out of here.
Story of my life, not wanted anywhere.
What?
Nothing, it's okay. Private joke.
I stared him right in the face and choked the life out of him, man.
Stay away from him, Jesse.
Yo, what do you want me to do? Just lay down and let the man walk all over me?
No. Right now you should calm down first. Don't do anything tonight. Just think about what you can do later. Look, don't get mad. Just get even.
You know, you're also needed someplace else, Jesse.
Like where?
Like the steam pit. You see, Greg is having a horrible time over there.
Nelson. I feel so bad the way I treated him, you know? And you too.
Forget it.
Come on. How can I forget the way I acted, Jenny? Talking about walking out on you, talking about selling my share to steam pit.
Don't start blaming yourself now. The guy was hustling you.
Can you imagine if I would have sold my share to Adam Chandler, man? That would have been death, man. That would have been...
But you didn't do it.
Myself. You would have hated me. I would have killed myself.
Jesse, it didn't
happen. Hey, look, I came close enough, okay? I came close enough. You're all my best buddies. You're my best friends. I almost dumped all over you.
We're not perfect either. I mean, come on. We shouldn't have given you such a hard time about these t-shirts.
Sorry about that, too.
I'm not. They paid off. You should see that place. It's packed, Jesse. And they're all waiting for you.
Yeah?
Yep.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Tell you what, I'm ready when you are.
Oh, good. Come on. Let's go. We'll see you later, Mrs. Baxter.
Oh, no. You're not going to see me later. I'm going to turn in tonight.
Okay. Do me a favor. Kiss my baby boy.
I will do that.
When he wakes up.
Okay.
Tell him I love him.
All right. See you guys.
How long is it going to be, Mr.
Mr. Hyde.
Oh, we should have his decision any moment now.
I wish I weren't so apprehensive.
Really? Why do you say that?
Well, Judge Myers was not too pleased to be summoned at this late hour, and I hope he doesn't take it out on us by deciding against us.
Oh, that's impossible, Palmer. Judge Myers wouldn't let such a personal consideration enter into his decision.
Well, there is another consideration.
What's that?
The Chandler money. It could have found its way into the judge's chambers.
Oh, for shame, Palmer. That kind of corruption couldn't happen here. I myself am confident of the result. After all, our cause is just, and justice shall prevail.
All My Children will continue in a moment.
Father, I gotta do something. My life is a mess.
Well, we've gotta turn it around. We've gotta get you in shape to be a father.
I told you.
I know. But you're still going to be a father no matter what Brooke does.
In name.
You're a father that this child is bound to know about. Don't you want to be somebody that your son or daughter will be proud of? Don't you want to have the ability to assume all of your responsibilities?
Yes. I want my self-respect back. I don't know if I have it in me.
Are you serious about wanting to help yourself?
I'm willing to try.
Are you willing to accept the help of others, including God's?
I don't have any choice.
Then I want you to pack your bag and come with me.
Where?
To a beautiful place by a lake deep in the woods.
A monastery?
Sort of.
Like a retreat?
Yes. It's a laid-back place, a good place to dry out. A good place to do some soul searching.
Will you help me pack my bag?
I'm very sorry that Adam isn't here.
Yes? Well, I'm not.
Oh, why not?
Because I wanted to do this. I'm gonna do that for a long time.
You did? Well, why haven't you?
Because I'm shy.
Why don't I believe that?
Come here.
You're a little overpowering here. And I don't want anything to happen here before I really understand what's happening.
Ellen, stop. What are you running away from me? There's nothing to be afraid of. You're a beautiful, beautiful woman. Okay?
I'm just a little anxious about the mall.
Well, speaking of changing subjects.
Yes, I would like to see the ground plans and the artist's sketches.
I have them upstairs. You really want to see them?
Yes, I would like to see them whenever.
Well, I'll get them now.
Good. Could I go upstairs with you?
Do you want to go upstairs?
Yes. I just think the downstairs is absolutely beautiful, and I've just been dying to see what the upstairs looks like.
Sure, follow the leader.
Okay.
Adam Chandler belong behind bars, not in a court of law and justice.
Good evening, Mrs. Wallingford.
Oh, there are not words base enough to describe the greedy, devious wretch that you are.
Shall we have a seat? Mm-mm.
You would take a wrecking ball to the Taj Mahal if you thought it would put a penny in your pocket.
This isn't the place, Mrs. Wallingford.
Now, don't you lecture me, Mr. Hines. That man deserves the opprobrium of every single decent citizen in this community.
You'd better calm down. You may have a stroke.
Now, Now listen to me. You are nothing but a liar. You're a deceiver.
Be quiet.
Attila the Hun!
Madam, you flatter me.
Oh, I'll see you hanged yet, you scoundrel!
Please, Mrs. Wallingford, you're not helping things.
Well, I'm only speaking the truth.
You mustn't make a scene in court.
And why not?
Because if Judge Myers hears you, he'll have you thrown out.
Phoebe, please sit down.
Oh, well, never mind. You'll be stopped, Adam Chandler, if I have to throw my body in front of your bulldozers.
We won't bother with the formalities because of the late hour. Take your seats, please. I have a petition here from Cortland Wallingford et al. For an injunction to stop Chandler Enterprises Incorporated from commencing the construction of a gambling mall. I have read the petition and am now ready to render my decision.
Listen, if you're glad I'm back, you're on the right track, Jack. That's right. Don't close the door, don't pull the shade. Because if you stick with Jesse, you got it made. I tell you what, so brace yourself to be undone, because this next release is on the one.
What? Hey, welcome back.
Again.
Yeah, baby. Oh, you're an apology, okay?
Hey, it's over and done with.
Hey, it never should have started.
Hey, come on. We all make mistakes. We just learn and keep going, huh?
Well, tonight sure taught me, I'm telling you. But now we can get back to running the steam pit the way we started out to do, okay?
Okay. Yeah, we're going to be closer than we ever were. Okay.
Speaking of close, Mrs. Nelson, how would you like to dance?
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Nelson.
Come on.
Let's go. Have fun, Mr. and Mrs. Hummer.
Leave us alone.
Well, this is my lucky night.
Why?
Running into you. It's like finding a long-lost friend.
Oh, really? Well, I don't think we really know each other that well.
Well, hey, you're a familiar face. I mean, I'm new in town.
Well, don't worry. What?
I don't know that many people yet.
Well, you're going to meet everyone, and then you'll just forget all about me. So,
I doubt that. What are my chances of seeing you again?
Good to excellent. But are you sure you want to?
Positive. Why?
Well, I'm sure you haven't forgotten about Jenny's shower.
I had, till you reminded me.
Really? I don't believe you.
It's true. I mean, Jenny and everything about her are a closed chapter in my life. You know, it's funny. It's as if it all happened to someone else.
But that must be really great, to be able to erase something like that.
What about you?
Oh, well, I really don't have much to forget. Look, I meant what I said. Just call me anytime. I'd love to go out with you.
You got it. Can I take you home?
Oh, no, but you can walk me to my car.
Lead the way.
Well, how about you stay here, and I have to make a quick stop. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okay.
Ross,
Wait a minute. Don't you think it's a little dark? You need to use a little light.
Dark at all. What are you talking about?
Well, look at all. Where do all these doors go? Where does that door go to?
That's the entrance to the West Wing.
Oh, could we take a look?
No, it's locked.
Well, do you have a key?
Yeah, but I don't have it on me.
Oh, well, why is it locked?
Well, that's the place that Adam does most of his painting. And most of it is just work in progress, and he doesn't want anybody to see it.
Oh, come on, not even you?
No, not even me.
Oh, well, you see, I used to do a lot of painting myself. That's why I'm interested in it. And I would just love to see somebody else's studio and their work. It would mean so much to me. Couldn't you get the key?
I can't.
But we could just sneak in. I know you could sneak right out. I promise I wouldn't touch anything.
We can't sneak out. We can't do... Look, that's an alarm system.
He really takes his work seriously, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. So come on now, okay? Forget about the West Wing.
I've read the arguments presented by the plaintiffs very carefully, and the case presented by these plaintiffs, Cortland Wallingford, et al., has not persuaded me to issue the injunction which they seek, at least not at this time. I shall therefore give said plaintiffs another 48 hours in which to prepare another brief. In that brief, I shall expect them to provide proof positive that the township of Pine Valley would suffer irreparable damage from said gambling mall proposed by Chandler Enterprises Incorporated. If the plaintiffs can provide such proof to my satisfaction, I shall then hand down the injunction to halt the construction of the mall. If they cannot, the construction may proceed. Now, Mr. Chandler, may I direct a word to you?
Yes, Your Honor.
I shall expect you to hold up the start of construction for 48 hours, or until I rule on the second brief. If you do commence construction before that time, I will issue an injunction to stop it.
I understand, Your Honor.
If that is all...
Excuse me, please, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Hines?
I respectfully request that the plaintiffs be given more than 48 hours to prepare this brief. 48 hours isn't time enough to gather the necessary testimony and data to prove irreparable damage from the gambling mall. I submit that 2 weeks would be a fair amount of time.
My decision stands. You have 48 hours. This hearing is adjourned.
To make your weekly payment to Meredy Marr, and you're gonna be able to put in enough extra to make a serious dinner to
tell me, baby. Tell me, baby. That's the kind of news I like to hear. Make me sleep good.
Well, you need to sleep good. I mean, it was a rough day with you nearly falling for that talent agency scam.
I tell you, they really took me. I couldn't believe I was so dumb to fall for something like that. I can't believe that I would fall for something like Adam Chandler, man. You know what?
What?
Most people would let him get away with something like that, but not me. It takes me the rest of my life. I'm gonna get him back. I swear, I'm gonna get it.
Everybody, grab a glass. I propose a toast.
Thank you, Joanna.
Thank you, Joanna.
Everyone? Joanna, you too? 48 hours from now, when construction begins.
Here. Oh, listen, let's not forget about the toast to Judge Myers.
Oh, here. Joanna, I want you to send a good judge tomorrow 6 cases of single malt 12-year-old scotch. That's his favorite. And make it anonymous, of course.
Oh. I'll take care of it first thing in the morning.
He's no fool. He'll know who sent it. More. Mm. More champagne, more.
Adam, take it easy a little, okay?
I'm celebrating. I have every right to celebrate. I've worked years for this moment. And now I'm finally seeing it happen. And I never could have done it, Ross, without you. And without you, Philip. And without you, Joanna.
I did nothing at all, Adam.
You took care of this house. Ellen, Joanna is much more than a housekeeper to us. She's like one of our family.
Oh, that's quite a compliment.
Yeah. We Chandlers appreciate loyalty. We'll never forget that you stood beside us on this.
Well, I think your ideas are very exciting.
That's because you're a very exciting businesswoman and a smart one. Ross, your companion has brains as well as beauty.
Well, I won't fight you there. I agree there. Where's Erica?
Oh, she turned in early. She had a very trying day. Trying to cope with the way this news was broken.
She didn't know.
No. I didn't want to burden her with it. But she's totally sympathetic.
Tell me something, Adam. Do you really think you're going to be able to begin all this in 48 hours?
Oh, absolutely. There's no way in the world I can prove a case of irreparable damage in 48 hours.
That Judge Meyer should be removed from the bench.
The ruling was an outrage against justice.
And Walter, do we have a chance?
Yeah, I'll put the entire firm on it right away. But we'll have to have a thorough environmental study, and that can't be done in 48 hours.
I just thought of something.
What, dear?
There's a special election the day after tomorrow.
What good will that do us?
Well, Mr. Hines, if we get enough signatures in time, then we could add a proposition to the special ballot, right?
Right.
We could write up a petition calling for a referendum.
A referendum for what?
A law to make gambling illegal in Pine Valley.
How many signatures would it take?
5,000. So I guess, being that it is the day after tomorrow, there wouldn't be time.
Oh, what a pity. I'm sure they would support us.
You say there wouldn't be time?
I'm afraid not, Mrs. Wallingford.
Shame on you. Shame on all of you. You're acting like a bunch of pusillanimous milksops.
Oh, really, Phoebe?
Well, I mean, you're just a fetus, that's all. We're giving up without even a fight.
But it can't be done.
Can't, sir, is not in my vocabulary. I, for one, shall start at dawn tomorrow collecting signatures. Anybody else with me?
Well, I'll join you. So will Myra and Sloan and Daisy.
Good. Anyone else?
Well, I'll certainly do my best.
Oh, bravo, sweetheart. Langley?
You can always count on me, love.
Well, I suppose we can try.
We can not only try, sir, we shall succeed. Oh, Adam Chandler, on guard, the voice of the people shall be heard!
Hear, hear!
Watch out.
This is David Hartman. Tomorrow on Good Morning America, Teddy Pendergrass tells about his auto accident and his remarkable recovery. Also, Bob and Ray, baseball Steve Garvey, and Treat Williams on Good Morning America.
Wednesday, cold fights to prove a former stunt buddy's innocence on The Fall Guy. Thursday, a lone wolf private detective bites the dust and comes back to earth as a crime-solving pooch and Oh Heavenly Dog. Chevy Chase, Jane Seymour, and Benji unleash the laughter on an ABC movie special. Now stay tuned for Family Feud.
On ABC's World News Tonight, Memorial.